Well, it's a beautiful September morning, and now that the smoke from the wildfires has cleared a bit, I'm heading up to the hike that I've been looking forward to all summer long, Garibaldi Lake. I haven't been up there for probably 30 years, but I'm really looking forward to it because it's such a gorgeous hike. So why don't you come along and enjoy it with me?
Take the Sea to Sky Highway northbound to reach Garibaldi Lake. Drive around 15 minutes past Squamish, and you'll see the Culloden Creek Bridge. From there, drive another 11.4 kilometers, watching out for the sign to Garibaldi Lake, and turn right onto the road that leads up to the trailhead. Another 2 or 3 kilometers along this road, and you'll be at the parking lot. Well, 9 o'clock, and I got the very last spot in the upper parking lot here. So it's a popular hike. If you want to get a spot, get it here early. Otherwise, you might have to park down the road and add a little bit of additional distance to your trip walking up towards the trailhead. This is a fairly strenuous trail with a total elevation gain of 2,700 feet and a round-trip distance of around 18 kilometers. From the parking lot, it climbs along the valley parallel to Rubble Creek at a moderately steep grade for a couple of kilometers before turning into a frontal assault on the mountain via a long series of switchbacks. It passes the junction to Taylor Meadows and then comes to the canyon wall, where a small side trail gives you a great view of the valley and the massive cliff wall known as the Barrier. Then it skirts two small lakes and makes a final climb before joining the other leg of the Taylor Meadows Trail and descending to the outlet of Garibaldi Lake. From there, a brief stroll along the water's edge brings you around the corner and into a full view of the lake and the glaciers that feed it far off on the other side.
Okay, got the hikers on and we're all set to hit the trail. But just before I start, I'm going to use the facilities. There's a couple of outhouses at the upper parking lot here, and they're the last facilities for quite a way, so best to make use of them. They're not in too bad shape. Toilet's decent and the paper's well stocked, so enjoy. And here we are at the start of the trail. It's about 9:25, so let's get underway. We've got a few hours of uphill to go before we get to the goal. There's a switchback that goes for about 100 meters or so above the parking lot, and then the trail turns towards Garibaldi Lake and starts heading upwards. It's a very popular trail, so expect to pass or be passed by lots of folks, depending on your level of proficiency. The trail crosses a few small creeks on the way, but as always, surface water is a bit suspect, so it's a good idea to bring along a plentiful supply of your own drink, because with the elevation gain of this trail, you're going to sweat a lot. The grade of the trail never really relents. It continues upward at a moderately steep angle for the first 6 kilometers or so. So pace yourself so you can enjoy the trail. It's very well graded and it's in excellent condition, although there was a bridge out earlier this year that didn't get repaired until the beginning of August. So it's a good idea to check the trail conditions before you leave. And at about 40 minutes in, we come to a switchback. This is the first in a series of switchbacks that are going to take us up a fair bit of elevation gain. And second turn in the switchback. And here we are at the third turn in the switchback. And this marks the 3 kilometer point. And there's a little section of trail here just before the fourth turn in this series of switchbacks that takes a much steeper little grade here. But don't get discouraged. The grade levels back out to its previous degree of difficulty right after the switchback. The switchback after the fourth turn is a very short one. We're right into the fifth turn almost right away. Number 5 is also a short one. Here we are almost immediately at the sixth turn. So we've passed the seventh switchback. Now the trail sort of straightens out a bit, goes up some more before we hit a second series of switchbacks. And a short way past that seventh turn, there's a little bit of a clearing where there's some nice logs. Make a good spot to take a break if you're so inclined. Me, I'm not winded, amazingly enough, and so I'm going to keep going. And after some straight trail, we come to the eighth turn, which starts a new series of small switchbacks to take us further up the mountain. And when we come to the ninth turn, we see a little marker here that says 4 kilometers. And so far, I've been going for about an hour and 15 minutes. And then in quick succession, turn number 10, turn number 11, number 12, number 13, number 14, number 15, number 16. And from here, we go more or less straight towards the barrier lookout. It's a pleasant forest walk amongst the sun-dappled trees. After a long straight stretch, we come to a series of 1, 2, 3 switchbacks. On this third switchback, there's a little trail here that goes to what looks like a viewpoint, but this isn't the actual barrier viewpoint. That one has a much better view. This one just gives you a little bit of an overlook of the valley. But there's too many trees in the way to really see anything. And here we are at the 6 kilometer mark. So I've been going almost exactly 2 hours, and that means I've been going about 3 kilometers an hour up this grade. I'm real happy with that. And over a little over 2 hours, 2 hours and 5 minutes, we come to the junction. One trail goes to the Garibaldi Lake campground. That's this trail that goes off in this direction here. And the other direction goes to Garibaldi Lake. And that's in this direction here. And in this direction, should you need it, is another outhouse. So, 2 hours from the parking lot, you got to make it without needing the facilities. But once you get here, you're golden. So, let's carry on towards Garibaldi Lake. And just a handful of minutes past the junction there, we come to another junction. This one takes us to the barrier viewpoint, which is a nice overlook of the barrier. So I'm gonna just take this little side trail. This is where I'll have my break, have some water, and take in the view for a bit. And we come around a corner, and suddenly we're on a big rock outcropping from which we get an incredible view of the Valley of Rubble Creek and the Valley of the Sea to Sky Highway. Far below is Rubble Creek, so named because it emerges from this immense pile of rubble, which has sloughed off the face of this immense cliff known as the Barrier. Well, it took me 2 hours and 15 minutes to get to the barrier viewpoint here, so I'm pretty pleased with that. And I feel a little bit of a blister coming in on my right heel, so I'm going to stop and put some moleskin on that, have a sip, have a Cliff Bar, and carry on.
The worst of the climb is behind us, so now we get to look forward to seeing Garibaldi Lake in all its glory. Okay, after about a 20-minute break at the barrier viewpoint, we're back to the fork in the trail, and I'm going to carry on towards the lake. At last, a stretch of trail where we're not going uphill. How novel, how refreshing, how pleasant. And in just a few minutes from the barrier viewpoint, we come to Barrier Lake. Partway around Barrier Lake, we see the 7-kilometer mark. And a couple more minutes past Barrier Lake, we get glimpses through the trees of Lesser Garibaldi Lake. And partway around the shores of Lesser Garibaldi Lake, we come to Taylor Creek. And this is the bridge that was washed out earlier this year. And I see on the concrete abutment, it says 2018. So this is a brand new bridge. You can imagine what was coming down this creek in the spring to wash this bridge out. They've done a very nice job of the replacement. Hopefully it'll last for many years. I just love that beautiful turquoise blue. After leaving Taylor Creek, the trail starts to rise again a few hundred feet. And as we depart Lesser Garibaldi Lake, we come to the 8-kilometer mark. Just about 5 or 10 minutes past the 8-kilometer mark, we reach the branch for Taylor Campground. And all along this section of the trail, you can hear the creek down in the canyon below, carrying water out of Garibaldi Lake, while at the same time leading us to its shores. There is one more turnoff before Garibaldi Lake, and that's the trail that goes over the mountain range towards Chicamas Lake. But that's not for us today. We're going down this way to see Garibaldi Lake. And we get glimpses of the lake through the trees as the trail descends towards its surface. And then suddenly the trail comes out on the outlet to Garibaldi Lake. And the first view of the lake itself. And a terrific view of the lake. Busy little boardwalk builders are at work. And finally, we come around the corner to get our first full view of the lake, which is truly spectacular. Well, it's about 10 after 1 o'clock. It took me about 3 hours and 40 minutes to get up here. So that's good. I was thinking it might be about 4 hours or so, and I wasn't too far off. There's a lot of washroom facilities here. Not only outhouses, but they've also got picnic tables and even some shelters in case the weather turns inclement. The shelters are pretty nice too. The campers use them to hang up their wet clothing to dry. This is the perfect spot to enjoy my bread garden breakfast wrap. Don't look at me, look at the view.
Well, the time has come to bid adieu to Garibaldi Lake. It's so beautiful up here. I'm so glad I came. Such a gorgeous day. A great way to spend it. It's about 2:30 now, and we're going to see how long it takes us to get back down. Okay. We're at the 4 kilometer mark. And the time is 4 o'clock. So that's about an hour and a half from the lake. Well, some hikers on the trail tell me that I passed the 1 kilometer sign. I didn't see the sign, but apparently it's there. All right, this is the last turn, just down before the parking lot. And we are almost back to the car where we can take a load off our feet. Yes, yes, here we are back at the parking lot. It's 4:57. So I made it down in a little less than 2.5 hours. That's good time. I'm pretty pleased with that. So it's about 3.5-ish hours up, if you don't count the stop at the barrier viewpoint, and 2.5 down. So 5 hours total travel time. That's really good. That's better than I thought I'd do. And here, here's where having gotten the last spot in the upper parking lot really pays off. So I don't have to walk that extra 50 meters to the car. Every meter counts big at the end of the hike, I'll tell you. Okay, dusty hiking shoes. That's the sign of a good hike, and it was a good hike. It's a lot of elevation gain, and you want to leave early in order to get a good parking spot, and also to be able to take a nice leisurely time, enjoy yourself. And if you do that, then you're going to have a really good time at the top. You really appreciate the views. It's one of BC's pure premier lakes to see, Garibaldi Lake. So I'm sure glad I went back, and I hope you do too. It's well worth the hike, in my opinion. And till my next hike, take it easy and don't break a leg.